In today's video, I'm going to be introducing you to a unit which is for one of my favorite types of chemistry. It's for Fischer-Tropsch chemistry. Fischer-Tropsch is a reaction where we convert synthesis gas, so a mixture of carbon monoxide, hydrogen, typically with CO2 and methane as well, to, in this case, paraffin, often over a cobalt-type catalyst, supported on alumina, titania, or silica. This is quite a unique Fischer-Tropsch unit in that we have combined CSTR reactors and fixed bed reactors in a single unit. This has a number of advantages, one of them being for a catalyst researcher, you can cover basically industrial applications, Shell Pearl probably being the most well-known one where the client uses a real fixed bed process for the large-scale FT process, or say Sasol, which is probably one of the most well-known large-scale implementers of Slurry's FT catalysts in their bubble column or ebullating bed reactors. You could address basically both processes in this single unit. The upstream and downstream of both of the processes are essentially the same. They're just sized a bit differently. One of the other advantages of having the CSTR, slurry, and the fixed bed in the same unit is that for people doing slurry's FT studies, the low dead volume of the fixed bed reactor has an advantage of responding very quickly to process variations. So if you're looking at the influence of pressure, temperature, flow, composition, etc. If you do it in a fixed bed reactor due to the low dead volume, you'll typically see within hours or at the most a day in your online GC the effect of having changed those process variables. CSTRs, by contrast, have fairly large dead volumes, and the large dead volumes mean that they tend to have quite a lag time before you actually see the impact of the process change you made. They do, however, much more closely simulate the process conditions of a bubble column or slurry bed. We're particularly good at ILS at making these CSTR slurry reactors for very long times on stream, so we actually have data for up to a year on stream here. They don't block due to slurry's fines, which is quite unique, and we also have a very simple but very robust way of maintaining the liquid level at a constant level over the course of months or years when you're doing long-term FT testing here. The unit itself is basically split into three sections. You've got the gas feed section here, where we dose all of our synthesis gas components. We have a small carbonyl trap, which removes any iron or nickel carbonyls formed by when the CO reacts with the gas bottle it's stored in. We have the reaction section here. All three reactors can be operated simultaneously. And we have the downstream section here. We tend to mount all of our downstream components in ovens like this because the user friendliness is much better. It's much easier to maintain, do leak testing. Here we have our hot pots for crashing out our paraffin. We can then do manual sampling of the paraffin here in the front in a sampling box here, which is nitrogen purge for safety reasons. We've made special throughputs in the oven here as well. It's very convenient. That way you can actually actuate the needle valves from outside the oven without having to open it during reaction. And at the bottom here, we have our sampling section where we crash out water, alcohols, anything that gets separated out at roughly 5 degrees Celsius. We measure the volumetric gas flow coming out using these Ritter volumetric flow meters here. Very important because FT is a reaction with a strong volumetric contraction, so we need to measure the gas flow in and the volumetric flow coming out. This unit also has an online hot tail gas, gas chromatograph, where we can measure the volume percent of all the components coming out. So with those volume percents and the volumetric flow rates coming out, we can measure the stoichiometric volume contraction and determine very accurately conversions, selectivities, make Flory-Schultz distributions. There is a separate unit which I won't be showing today here, which is our pre-reduction reactor. We have to pre-reduce the catalyst in a small quartz fixed bed reactor for these slurry reactors. Doing it in situ in a slurry reactor is really not realistic. So you typically pre-reduce your slurry's catalyst in a small fixed bed quartz reactor, transport it under an argon blanket, and then add it to the slurry's reactor where you've got some melted wax inside to prevent your pyrophoric pre-reduced catalyst from reacting with any of the air. That's basically it in a nutshell. It's a completely automated unit. We have a recipe control system on this so you can create multi-step recipes beforehand. The GC is also fully integrated, and we'll be shipping this unit off in just a few weeks.